still in Parliament, sugarcane farmers from Luka District have petitioned the Parliament to rein in sugar millers who have denied them permits to sell their sugar canes. Farmers handed their petition to the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, and asked her to save sugarcane growers who are stuck with their produce in the garden, yet they still have obligations to clear. Let's see what happened.
They cleared our sugar canes in the computer. We have nowhere to sell the sugar canes, yet the sugar canes are on the land. Now they are becoming to 4 to 10 years.
According to these sugar cane growers, over 300 farmers in Luka District have been affected by the unfair policies of sugar millers who have denied them permits to sell sugar canes. The group told the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, that they were moved by Madivan of Kakira Sugar Works to cut their gardens and plant sugar cane, but they have been disappointed at the time of harvest when the same factory failed to issue permits and abandoned their sugar canes.
The first they were serving us well, but eventually in the long run, we are neglected poorly. So that's why people are committing suicide, because Kakira Sugar Works requested us to plant sugar cane, such that Kakira will buy our sugar cane and pay the loans from Tropical Bank. And over now, Kakira is not buying our sugar cane.
They claim to be stranded on what to do next because the loan grace period elapsed and they have no money to service their loans.
They are giving their summonies. Demanding for their money. That if we don't give them paper, the money, they are going to sell
our lands,
our properties.
Madivani was the guarantor. He was the guarantor of the farmers. To the Tropical Bank.
To be given loans.
So he has now betrayed them?
Yes.
They add that three of their colleagues have committed suicide after failure to stand the pressure exerted to them by the banks.
Three people were committed suicide because of the debts of the bank, Tropical Bank. Because the Tropical Bank has shot many farmers to the court.
The group want Parliament to intervene and bring to order Kakira Sugar Works and Mayuge Sugar for adopting policies which are causing sugarcane farmers huge losses.
Luka District, we don't have any source of income or generating income, only to grow sugarcane, whereby Kakira Sugar Works requested us to be helping each other such that we can gain to live and support our families.
I'm going to call Mr. Madvani and Mr. Magan Patel to come here in our next time. And I've asked for two representatives from each of the two farming groups to come here and resolve the issue of the farmers, because these are their contract farmers. They're not just any farmers. They're contracted by the sugar factories. Therefore, they should be able to buy their cane.
To sell their sugar cane, farmers have to jump hurdles, including enlisting in sub-county cooperatives and acquiring permits. According to Godfrey Biriwali, the Great Busoga Sugarcane Growers Union Chairman, a permit costs between 1.7 million shillings to 3.5 million shillings. Besides being costly, the news observed that securing it is cumbersome and time-consuming. Farmers also accuse the local leaders of bribery, influence peddling, and politicizing the process. At the factory, especially during the times of plenty and congestion, trucks take 3 to 4 days to offload, attracting a 5% sugar charge. In Kalira District, leaders with permits are paying shillings 60,000 per acre for reachable shambas and 40,000 for distant ones. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Parliament.